Jaylen Samuels is one of the most unique players in the NFL. That is indisputable. He can play at every skill position. Yes, running back, wide receiver, and even tight end. He showed some real promise in his rookie season with the Pittsburgh Steelers, but should continue to emerge as an elite all-around offensive weapon for years to come. Collegiately, Samuels suited up for the North Carolina State Wolfpack. Throughout his career at NC State, Samuels changed positions, being listed as a running back, fullback, wide receiver, and tight end. Samuels was one of the best offensive players in Wolfpack history and was a key contributor to the team. Samuels had three seasons with at least 55 catches, 500 receiving yards, and 6 rushing touchdowns. That is absurd. During his senior season, Samuels set the NC State record for career receptions with 202 during his 4 years. Following his senior season, he was honored as first-team All-Conference as an all-purpose player, as well as third-team AP All-American as a tight end. He finished his college career with 1,851 receiving yards, 1,107 rushing yards, and 47 total touchdowns. Yet, as an NFL prospect, many teams had no clue what to do with Samuels. He was a great receiving tight end in college, but he only stands at about 6 feet tall. He was an effective running back, especially in short yardages and in the red zone, but he never was a bell cow running back of the offense. I mean, he never got more than 12 carries in any single game. He's also pretty fast, running a 4.5/4.40, but that's not hyper elite for either position. Regardless of the question, Samuels was selected 165th overall in the 5th round in the 2018 NFL Draft by the Pittsburgh Steelers. Immediately, Pittsburgh made it clear that they viewed Samuels primarily as a running back. At the time, the Steelers did not seem like an ideal landing spot. I mean, after all, they had one of the best tailbacks in the league, Le'Veon Bell. Yet due to Bell's ignorant holdout, it looked like an opportunity would arise for Jaylen. Unfortunately for Samuels, James Conner proved to be an elite running back in his own right, and the Steelers seemed perfectly content to ride Conner for as long as they could. However, Jaylen's opportunity would finally come. Due to a Week 13 injury to Conner, Samuels earned his first career NFL start in Week 14 against the Oakland Raiders. In the game, Samuels rushed for 28 yards on 11 attempts and caught 7 passes for 64 yards in a 24-21 loss. The following week against the New England Patriots served as Samuels' true breakout game. Samuels rushed 19 times for 142 yards and caught 2 passes for 30 yards in a 17-10 win. His 142 rushing yards marked the second most by a rookie in Steelers history. Overall, Samuels finished his debut campaign with 256 rushing yards and 26 receptions for 199 receiving yards and 3 touchdowns. He really started to build momentum towards the end of the season and should keep it pushing for 2019. He can form quite a formidable 1-2 combination with Conner. But let's break down Samuels' game a little bit more. What makes him unique and what makes him a good player in the NFL for years to come, at least in my opinion. As a receiving back in the NFL, Samuels is phenomenal. He's a quick receiver who nets excellent routes and has soft hands. Samuels is dangerous and carves up coverage in the underneath part of the field. He's a dynamic mismatch weapon against linebackers and safeties. With his versatility, Samuels can run routes from a variety of places. He did that in college and can do that in the NFL, most certainly. Samuels can line up as an H-back, traditional tailback, fullback, slot receiver, or even line up next to the line as an undersized tight end. He's very dangerous on quick slants, crosses, outs, and wheel routes. Samuels is also phenomenal on screens in the flat. He has a quick burst to get upfield and is elusive with the ball in his hands. Defenders really struggle to run with Samuels as he's a real mismatch problem running routes against linebackers and safeties. As a halfback, Samuels is a quick cutter who has a burst to get to the second level. He's an elusive runner who will zigzag around tacklers. Samuels has subtle quickness with the ability to break off some trunk runs as he can dart to the second level. At over 220 pounds, Samuels is also put together well with the ability to lower his shoulder and power through defenders. In short yardage and goal line situations, Samuels is an asset as he possesses a real nose for the end zone. He's a real mismatch weapon as a receiver out of the backfield. He also can take carries and run up the middle, so Samuels presents a lot of problems for defenses when they're spread out defending a passing-driven offense. Once Samuels develops his blocking, he could be a three-down starter in a passing-driven offense. Samuels may never be the kind of back who logs 300 plus carries in a season, but he could end up getting 20 to 30 touches per game as a receiver and runner. Still, next year and in the immediate future, Samuels looks to be Conner's backup, or complement, in Pittsburgh. It would be wise for the Steelers to take more of a running back by committee approach, and Samuels figures to be a key component of that equation. Whatever his role is, I will be excited to watch Jaylen Samuels, and you should be too. Comment down below, what are your thoughts on Jaylen Samuels? Who do you think is the most versatile player in the NFL? Share the video with your friends and leave a like if you enjoyed. Feel free to subscribe to the channel for similar videos and follow me on Twitter and Instagram at RespectThePoint. That is all for this video. Thank you for watching. Goodbye and have a nice day.